solving trigonometric equations, a la Shmoop. Kalico is in a precarious situation. She naively volunteered to sit in the dunking booth at a carnival to help raise money for the vet club at school. Kalico is doomed to her Kool-Aid dunk if the next person in line doesn't quickly and correctly solve the following trigonometric equation. Tangent squared of x minus 3 equals 0 for the interval 0 is less than or equal to x is less than or equal to 2 pi. As fate would have it, Speedy, the slowest dog in town, is in line to try to solve her question. She feels as if she may be Kool-Aid bound for sure. He grabs the marker and begins solving the equation by factoring the expression. If we factor the expression tangent squared of x minus 3, like the difference of two squares, we'll have the expression the quantity tangent of x minus square root of 3 times the quantity tangent of x plus square root of 3. In a bold move, he is now setting each of the quantities equal to 0. He knows that if their product together is 0, then one or both of them must be equal to 0. Solving each of the equations with a speed we frankly didn't think possible for him, he ends up with two equations. Using a technique he must have studied with his trigonometry teacher, he is taking the inverse tangent of both of the equations to solve for x. Reaching far back into the recesses of his canine brain, he recalls that the inverse tangent of root 3 is pi over 3, and the inverse tangent of negative root 3 is 2 pi over 3. Speedy realizes that we've found two answers within an interval of pi, because both pi over 3 and 2 pi over 3 are less than pi. That makes sense because the tangent function has a period of pi, which means it goes through one full cycle for every pi radians. Since Speedy is looking for all answers between 0 and 2 pi, he has to consider the answers between pi and 2 pi also. In order to find those values, he needs to add pi to each of the answers he already has. So,
to add pi to pi over 3, we must first make sure both numbers have the same denominator. We can multiply 3 over 3 to pi to make it have the common denominator of 3. When adding fractions, we add across the top and keep the denominator the same. So 3 pi over 3 plus pi over 3 equals 4 pi over 3. To add pi to 2 pi over 3, we again have to make sure both numbers are under the same denominator. We can again multiply 3 over 3 to pi to get 3 pi over 3 plus 2 pi over 3. Adding across the top numbers, we get 3 pi plus 2 pi equals 5 pi over 3. So his final answers are x equals pi over 3, 4 pi over 3, 2 pi over 3, and 5 pi over 3. Done. Woof. Unbelievable. Speedy has solved the trig equation. Unfortunately, the dunk tank malfunctions, and Kalico gets drenched anyway.